Amen. We're gonna read together.
Amen.
Read this morning. Psalm 23:1 says, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of my enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Amen. Amen. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading and the hearing of his word. You may be seated. Praise God. The 23rd Psalm. In my heart, a lot of times, really don't need a topic.
Come on now.
Sometimes we look for some familiarization topic to help us remember what was talked about. But in this case, all you gotta do is say the 23rd Psalm.
Amen.
And somebody say, "I know what you're talking about."
Oh, yeah.
Praise God. I mean, down through the years, it's been one of the church's favorite songs.
Yes.
Praise God. The 23rd Psalm. Somebody say, "Well, you know, praise God." Amen. How many verses, amen, is contained in the 23rd Psalm? No, there's only 6 verses. Praise God, and I often knew that, or some may have known, but some may have forgot because there's so much in those 6 little verses.
Yeah.
Praise God. Yeah. That you would think it's like 10 or 12 verses in the 23rd Psalm. But that's not the case. Praise God. 6 verses in the 23rd Psalm. You know, sometimes just to let your mind go into the fact or look at how good God really is to you.
Thank you.
As an individual.
Right, yes.
You know, sometimes we can get caught up on other things that may not be going like we want them to go.
Come on now.
Praise God. But sometimes we ought to look around and say, "Lord, you've been good to me.
Oh, yes.
I really have no need or no reason to complain because, God, you've been good to me."
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Yes.
Sometimes I go in my car and I just ride around, especially when they had the different floods in different locations. I say, "God, you kept my house from being flooded.
Come on now.
My basement could have been filled with water.
Right.
Praise God. A devastation could have came my way. But God, it was because of you."
Hallelujah.
Praise God. Amen.
Yes.
And how you've been to me.
Yes.
And I just want to praise God and recognize the fact, praise God, in my life, that I know, praise God, who's directing my life. Sometimes you got to know that you know, amen, who's directing your life. I say, God, it could have been a whole different case. Praise God. Amen. I ain't got no, praise God, right, so to speak. We got a Bill of Rights, you know, American. I got my rights. And ain't got no right.
Come on,
praise God. It ain't no day promised to no man or woman. On this planet.
Well,
praise God. It's by the grace of God that you're here.
Amen.
I say, "Lord, a lot of things could have happened to me years and years ago.
Come on now.
But it was you that brought me thus far."
Praise God.
When I look at my life and look at the things that took place, and you wonder how you get to the stage, I just have to throw up my hands and say, "God, it's because of your goodness." Sometimes you ought to just look at the goodness of God.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord.
Mm-hmm. And what he's done.
Yes, yes, yes.
Somebody said, "When I think of the goodness of Jesus,
yes,
and all that he's done for me,
yes,
my soul cries out."
Yes.
Hallelujah. I thank God for saving me.
Yes, yes.
one time a preacher, praise God, it must have been back in the 90s. Praise God, I can still hear him. I don't even know what he preached about. And he preached. But before he started preaching, praise God, amen, he had this testimony. And he was talking about the things that he done wrong in his life. And he said, I made a lot of mistakes. And if I had an opportunity, praise God, to do them, I'd probably do something different. I messed up in my life. Mm-hmm. Some people flee like their lives is just completely over because there's too much water under the bridge. Mm-hmm. He said, I've done a lot of things right I can't correct. Yeah. I've done a lot of things that I felt bad about, praise God. Mm-hmm. I looked back at my life and I felt, he said, but this one thing, mm-hmm. praise God, I'm so glad that I did. He said, that's when I gave my life to the Lord.
All right.
He said, that's one thing you'll never regret. Giving yourself over to God. Yes. Amen. That is one chunk in under your name, praise God, that you're going to be saying hallelujah throughout eternity.
Yes.
Praise God, I saw the light. In that song, I saw the light.
Thank you.
No more darkness. No more night. Glory, hallelujah. I saw the light.
Yes, Lord.
David went through a lot in his life.
Mm-hmm.
David's life is exposed all over Scripture.
Yes.
Praise God. I'm glad my life is last. But David's life exposed all over the good, the bad, and oh yeah, the ugly.
Yeah.
It's all in there.
Yeah.
Praise God. Amen. Sometimes, praise God, we think, amen, everything has to be, praise God, perfect. Amen. In order for us to give God some praise. But God said this about David. David was a man after God's own heart.
Amen. Yes. Come on now.
Yes.
Yes, he was.
You know, and I really looked at that. And I said, what was that? Mm-hmm. See, David knew how to repent.
Mm-hmm. Yes,
David knew how to repent.
Yes.
Praise God. He knew how to, praise God, turn it over to the Lord.
Yes.
Amen. He went and exposed by Nathan and said, David, yes. You're the man.
Mm-hmm.
Praise God. David, amen, knew how to go to the Lord.
Yes.
And see, once you turn it over to the Lord, once we give it back over to him, God said, praise God, said this word, amen, I'll cast your sins away as far as the east is from the west. And I'll remember them no more. Praise God.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. And so David went through a lot. And in a lot of the Psalms, David explained and talked about some of the turmoil and how good God was and how he brought him through and how he was worthy, praise God, to be praised.
Amen.
Amen. Praise God. Well, he knew David was, amen, and for lack of a better word, had a lot of complaints about what the enemy was doing, but how God gave him the strength to overcome.
Yeah.
But when he got to the 23rd Psalm, amen, amen. When the Spirit of the Lord came upon David, praise God, and he started to pen the 23rd Psalm, this is strictly a psalm of comfort.
Yes.
Amen. David had to say, praise God, within himself, who God is to him? Who is God to you? Scripture used a lot of symbolic symbols. Praise God. And David, being a shepherd man, knew what it was like to care for the sheep. Knew that a good shepherd, praise God, constantly had his eyes out on his sheep.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Knew that there were dangers that was out there.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. There were, praise God, predators,
yes.
Amen, out there,
yes.
Looking to destroy your life. There's situations and circumstances out there, praise God, amen, looking, amen, to get up on the sheep. There were pastures that they couldn't graze in because it may be some bad grass out there, praise God, amen. But he knew that a good shepherd,
right.
Hallelujah, always looked out ahead.
Uh-huh.
had a foresight to see. I want my sheep over there. I don't want them over here, praise God. I see some flaws over in this pasture here, but I want them over there. He knew that a good shepherd constantly cared for the sheep. David had a shepherd's heart. So when he penned that, he said, listen, praise God, the Lord is my shepherd. You got to make this thing personal.
Right.
I mean, sometimes, you know, he's all of our God. He's the God of the universe. And he's the God of the, wait a minute, he's my God. Hold on a minute. I don't know what he is to you. Praise God, but he's my God. See, he's opened doors and he's made ways for me, praise God, that nobody else can make. He's covered my heart, praise God, late in the midnight hour when I couldn't get no comfort. And if I feel like just crying all night long, praise God, he knows what the situation and what the circumstance is. Praise God, and then the next day, I feel mighty good. Praise God. He made it personal. The Lord is my shepherd.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. When the days are good, he's my shepherd. When the days, and praise God, are kind of cloudy, he's yet my shepherd. Praise God. When things are going smooth and everything's all right, he's my shepherd. When things are going kind of chaotic and out of hand, he's yet my shepherd. Praise God. When I'm up, praise God, he's my shepherd. When I'm down, he's my shepherd. He's my shepherd 7 days a week. He's my shepherd 24 hours a day. He's my shepherd. Somebody don't understand. The Lord is my shepherd. He's the shepherd and the bishop of your soul.
Come on now.
Praise God. David got personal with me.
Yes, he is.
Praise God. He's my shepherd. A shepherd cares. A shepherd is concerned.
Yes.
A shepherd knows. Amen. And he got them on four different areas about what the shepherd does for him. Does for him. Mm-hmm. Praise God. One, he said, he make me lie down.
Woo! Amen.
In green pastures.
Yes.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen. In the green pastures. Praise God. He know, praise God, what the hiccup, so to speak, in life are. He know what the trouble is in life.
Yes.
Praise God. Amen. And sometimes, praise God, he has to tap me on the shoulder. Thump me up that head. Say, you ain't got no business over here. I prepared this pastor for you now. What are you doing over there? Amen. I got a place for you. I want to put you where I prepared for you. God has a purpose for your life. He's got a place for your life. He's got something already laid out and prepared for your situation. For you as an individual.
Look at God. Look
here. He's prepared a place for you.
Yes,
praise God.
Amen.
Lay down in green pastures.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God. He leads me beside the still waters.
Yes.
He leads. That's the same thing. God leads.
Mm-hmm.
See, praise God. Any other leader, praise God. Amen. Outside the voice of God. Amen. Will lead you anywhere they want to lead you.
Mm-hmm. Right.
May lead you to a barren field.
Come on now.
May lead you into all kinds of trouble. But see, God will never lead you in that direction.
Thank you.
God will never lead you off base. And praise God. God will lead you beside the still waters. God ain't going to take you into troubled times.
Yes.
Praise God. Even though troubled times may come, praise God. He said, I'll be with you. Praise God. Even until the end of the earth. Praise God, but this shepherd, praise God, is going to lead you, amen, through the troubled waters, amen, beside the still waters.
Yes.
Yes.
Amen.
Still waters got a lot to do with your nutrition.
Yes, amen.
Yo, praise God now. We look on a natural state, physical body, praise God. You want to get a drink of water, ain't nothing like going down by the cool, still waters.
Amen.
Praise God. I remember, praise God, when I was in the Marine Corps, praise God, back in 1978, and we had to do a little course on reading the terrain, and we was up in the mountains. Praise God. We had a little map, and we had to read the little map. We had to get from one checkpoint to the next checkpoint to the next checkpoint. We had to get to them in order and this and this and that. But praise God, in these mountains, praise God, amen. And this is Bridgeport, California. At the top of these mountains, in the middle of July, they had snow. It's 70 degrees up there. 70 degrees. Praise God, down below, but in the mountains, you had snow. And the ice would melt, the snow would melt, and the water would be so clear. And the guys would just take the canteen from hiking and put it down in that water, and that water was so fresh. Praise God, and run over those, and they just drank that water. And that water. Water looked so good. I was ever drinking that water was some of the freshest water I had ever tasted. Coming right off the mountain. Praise God. Amen. And when I think of that, God is going, got the nutrition, praise God, the set for your spirit already laid out. Amen. The water, praise God, that represents life to you, that represents the spirit to you. Praise God. God already got it figured out. Amen. The things that you need. Amen. That he'll lead you beside the very still waters. Praise God. Hallelujah. He restored my soul.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Praise God. He restored my soul. David said, like nobody else can. Praise God, he restores. Praise God. When you get down and out, so to speak, praise God, the Spirit of God come in and it lifted you. Praise God, the old song said it was love that lifted me. Praise God, when I was sinking deep in sin, far from the people, sure. Praise God, praise God. Love lifted me. Praise God. Lifted you out of the muck and the mire. Lifted you out of depression. Lifted you out of your circumstances. Let you know, praise God, everything's going to be all right. Amen. Let you know, praise God, when you're worried about how things going to turn out. God said, I've been with you so far, and I'm going to take you all the way.
Yes.
He knows how to restore a spiritual man.
Yes.
Praise God.
Yes.
He restored, praise God, my soul. And hallelujah. He leads me in the path of righteousness for his name's sake.
For his name's sake.
See, praise God. We got a tag on us. We got to show with the people of God. We talked a little bit about it on Thursday night. We're ambassadors for Christ.
Yes.
Praise God. Amen. I believe people really believe that the more we can really put our trust in God's word, amen, the more we'll see, praise God, how God is operating in our lives. See, God can do anything but fail.
That's right. That's right. Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah. When we turn it over to him.
Yes.
Praise God. Yeah. As we talk about, amen, the very God that made the universe.
That's it.
Woo! Made all creation. Amen. Is Archbishop of our souls. Amen. Praise God. He knows how to open the door. He knows, praise God, how to lead us in the path of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I'll fear no evil. He said, when you're going through it, you're going to go through it. At times you're going to go through, praise God, amen. Like nobody else can understand. You're going to go through. And David went through. He went through some harsh times. He went through some troubled situations. He went through some turbulent times. Praise God. Amen. And this country is going to go through some times.
Oh, yes, it is now.
And you ain't got your prayer won't turn it. Praise God. We're looking at what's going on with these elections. So some of us are keeping and kind of listening. And I see no hope. I see not very much hope.
Amen.
I say, if it wasn't for the Lord, I say, I'll tell you who's my boss for. My boast of the Lord.
There you go.
God's going to work this thing out.
Yes. Yes.
It's way too complicated for man.
Yes.
Praise God. It's way out of their hands.
Yes.
Praise God. We hear the stuff that's going on. That stuff will drive you crazy. Praise God. But you know, praise God, that it's in the hands of the Lord. Praise God. said, for thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Praise God. Don't ever look at God's correction as something to get frustrated about.
Amen.
When God say, leave something alone, leave it alone.
That's it. That's it.
Said, turn it loose, turn it loose. Praise God. God, praise God, desires, hallelujah, for our lives to be, praise God, for his glory.
Yes, yes.
For his glory.
Amen.
Your rod and staff, comfort.
Yes.
Comfort. Comfort. Sometimes God challenges. It challenges, praise God, amen, and our faith and what we really believe. Oh, we're doing things, praise God, just because we really trust in him. God will challenge you.
Oh, yes.
And some simple things. Sometimes they're challenging your finances. Some of your time they're challenging you on your job. Sometimes they're challenging you in your routine and how you do things. Praise God. Amen. Sometimes just listen to the small, still voice of the Lord. Praise God. Amen. Speak it to your heart.
Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. You know, it's hear me at work. I always have my hat on at work. Praise God, just the habit of just something I do. Praise God, amen. I used to do it years ago, just stopping from all the dust and whatnot, getting my hair, just a habit. But one day, praise God, Lord asked me, praise God, now listen to him and say, Gary, I want you to wear your hat today. I'm like, because I always wear my hat, you know. But it came to me just to clear again, don't wear your hat today. I said, Lord, if this is you speaking, praise God. I'm not going to do it. It ain't that big of a deal that I have on my hat. Praise God. I threw the hat off and went on to work. It must have been 15 people, maybe even more. Gary, you left your hat on. Gary, you don't have it. I'm like, don't you think I know that? I mean, I'm the one that's walking through. When I got done, I got back, I ran back home, and I thought, I said, well, I'm done with the Lord saying. I said, how many people talked to you today about that? I'm thinking, probably 15. That's 15 opportunities to witness.
Amen. Look at God. Look at
him. And it's just what it was. If the Lord told you to do it, and they ask you, what am I going to do? I said, I'm throwing out every other reason except by what God told me about. Praise God. Sometimes God will speak to your heart in a small, still voice. Praise God to get your attention. He may want to change your routine. May want to change the way you do things. He may want to change up some things about your life. Amen. He may want to change some new things. He may want to do it by. He's the one that leads you. He's the one that guides you. Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Yes. Praise God. Though I walk through the valley of shadow of death, praise God, you are with me, your rod and your staff, you comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemy. Prepare a table before you in the presence, before the presence. Those, some complainers about, praise God, what you're doing and about your life. This, in a sense, praise God to me, is when God opened the door for your life. I don't care what folks say. Praise God. That door is prepared for you.
Yes.
They had nothing to do with it.
That's it.
They can't shut it. They didn't open it. Praise God. When God got certain things for your life, right in the presence of your enemies, God will, praise God, work a miracle over your situation, and people don't understand why. Or how? Or what? Praise God. And it's for the glory of the Lord.
Yes.
I don't care what the enemy say and what he do. Praise God. He cannot stop God from working in your life. Yes. He can't do it. Old preacher used to say, hey, the devil can't box with God. His arms too short.
Yes.
Praise God. When God prepares something in your life, praise God, it's going to come to pass.
Ooh,
hallelujah. He's got it laid out. Praise God. In the presence of my enemy, you anoint my head with oil. Praise God. Anoint his head with oil. The anointing of the Lord. praise God, is upon your life. The anointing of the head is kind of symbolic, praise God, amen, to God working in your life to prosper you in this life, praise God, to make sure you got the things, hallelujah, that you need in this life. Praise God, is a symbol of abundance. God poured the oil upon your head to anoint his favor upon you. Amen. The anointing of the Lord, praise God, is upon his people.
Amen.
Praise God. Don't let that anointing wear off. Praise God, if you feel like you're losing the anointing, get down on your knees.
Amen.
Say, anoint me again, oh Lord. Anoint me, praise God, with your oil. Hallelujah, that the favor, praise God, will be upon our lives. The areas that you're hurting in, the areas that you need healing in, praise God, anoint me there. Praise God, the same with the sheep, praise God, used to get scratched when they would fall down and get sores and get wounded. David would, praise God, grab the oil, the shepherd would grab the oil, praise God, and begin to rub it on the sheep, praise God, to heal that wound. Whatever that wound was, whatever that soreness was, whatever that pain was, amen, David would look and care, or the shepherd would look and care for the sheep to see if they got any kind of injuries, anything that's wrong, and praise God, he would go up, praise God, and put some oil on them, praise God, to heal that wound. And that's what God does with his people. Sometimes you may stumble, sometimes you may fall. Don't stay down. Say, Lord, anoint me again. You know every wound. Hallelujah. He'll anoint you.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
To his favor. Hallelujah.
Oh, bless your name.
And it says, surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I'll dwell in the house of the Lord.
Amen.
Forever. 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 God's presence and his goodness and his mercy.
Oh, yes, Lord.
Praise God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. So follow me all the days. All the days.
Yes.
All the days.
Hallelujah.
Now, I don't like to repeat a whole lot of stories that I hear. Praise God. I can't verify them, so to speak, but I did hear the testimony. I brought this lady, praise God, this young girl, praise God, was witnessing, amen, to this individual, amen, on the street. And every time, praise God, this, trying to witness, praise God, this one man was saying, oh, that's a bunch of hocus pocus stuff. Mm-hmm. This world is way too complicated for that one book to have it all figured out. And if God so loved the world, praise God, amen, why is all these things tend to happen like they happen? Why so much destruction? Praise God, amen. And the girl all said, we kept saying, I don't know, but all I know is God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son.
Mm-hmm.
That whosoever believeth in him should not perish. Mm-hmm. Praise God. And say again, praise God, why are these things like they are? You got to give me some kind of explanation if you want me to follow you. And she kept on just repeating the scripture. And she said, all I know is that goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life.
Yes.
All the days of my life. All the days of my life.
Yes.
All the days of my life. Praise God. That gentleman said, I walked away. Praise God. Hallelujah. Next thing you know, praise God. Hallelujah. Here he comes. Praise God. Knocking on her door. Found out where she lived at. Praise God. She opened the door and the man took out running. Took out running. And she's like, that is really strange. Praise God. And a couple hours later, came back. Praise God. Came back almost bowing down to her. Said, who was that? She said, who was who? Who was that you had with you when you opened the door?
Wow.
He said, nobody's in there except me that I know about. He said, no, you had two big men right there by your side and looking at me like they was about to jump on me. I ain't never seen nothing like that before in my life. Praise God. That man came back and gave his life to Christ. You got angels standing by your side.
Amen.
That you're not aware of. David said, bless you, brother, like this. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the good. Don't you ever think that you're all alone, that nobody cares. God's got his witnesses. He's got his angels watching over you. Watching over you day and night. Praise God. They belong to us. They sent out from heaven to guard over his people. Praise God. Goodness and mercy. God is a shepherd. Jesus said, I am the good shepherd. Yes. I am the door. Yes. I am the way. He said, no man cometh unto the Father but by me. Praise God. I'm the shepherd. Praise God. The gift of Christ for the sheep. I am the shepherd. Praise God. The gift of life to you. That you might have a right to eat from the tree of life. The good shepherd. Yes. He's the only way. The way, the truth, and the life. Amen. Praise God. Praise God is bound to Christ. Praise God. He's the shepherd and the bishop of our souls. Praise God. Be encouraged. Be encouraged. Those dreams that you got. Praise God. God prepared. Be encouraged. Don't give up on the Lord. Don't give up on the things that he's promised you.
Yes.
Amen. Be confident. Hallelujah. Amen. If God spoke it, it'll come to pass.
Oh, yeah.
Praise God. Let us stand to our feet.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Lord is our shepherd.